either at risk of a nuclear catastrophe from nuclear waste stored at the closed San Onofre plant, or safe as can be. Depends on whom you ask, among those who've studied nuclear plant safety for years. And Alison, tell us who these folks are and what they're concerned about, how their viewpoints differ.
Well, it's worth making the point at the beginning that actually now that the plant is decommissioned, it is safer than it was when it was operating. However, the difference is that it's not making money for the utility, and so the amount of oversight and the security procedures that used to be in place could be less now. So that's kind of where the risk lies. And, you know, we have people saying such different things that it's quite hard to pin down, you know, what is actually the truth. There are people who really say that, you know, there could be an explosion. And then we have the NRC, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, that is saying that there's no danger now that it's just spent fuel of anything leaving the site. So you have the question of, well, what could happen, and also when could it happen? Because many people say, really, there is not a very high risk right now, but over time, if the nuclear is essentially waste, the high level spent fuel is stored there, that over time there is not really the adequate planning to make sure that it will stay safe for indefinitely.
And the Nuclear Regulatory Commission meeting here this week, and was this the main issue there? And
well, basically what they're trying to decide is whether Southern California Edison, which had a near-miss accident last year,
The main owner of the plant,
whether they should be allowed to resume moving this waste from one place to another. So it was a very interesting hearing yesterday, and I will say that the NRC did ask some pretty tough questions of Southern California Edison. I think many people are afraid of this phenomenon of regulatory capture, you know, where the regulating agencies may be sort of too connected to the utilities. But I did see the NRC commissioners asking some quite tough questions, such as, do you have a contingency plan if something were to happen? And Edison was not really able to respond. They basically said, we don't think anything's going to happen, and if it did, we'd have time to figure it out. So the NRC said, when we come back and do a follow-up inspection, before we let you continue, we're going to ask you about your contingency plan.
And Southern California Edison's point of view on all this?
Well, I mean, they're basically saying, yes, we were at fault, and mea culpa, and management didn't realize how complex this was going to be, and we realized we have to do a lot to improve the situation. So they have put in a number of things that they should have put in the first place, training. The people who were overseeing the operation were actually not particularly trained in Holtec, that's the designer of the system. They weren't trained in the system, the high storm UNEX system. So Edison is making a big effort to show that it will do better next time. And I think the public has really got to really start to hold their feet to the fire, because they've lost a lot of trust.
A lot of this centers on what's going to happen to these spent fuel rods. Is there any chance that they could be moved off-site?
That is, of course, everybody's hope. Even the engineers who say there is no risk to the public health offsite, they say, well, we want to finish the process. We've generated energy, and now we need to finish the process. We need to move that fuel offsite to somewhere else. So even though they say it's safe, they say not in the long term. We have to move it. And at the moment, there is nowhere, and Congress is very tied up, as we know, with other matters. So the chances of agreeing on an alternative site remain murky.
And this is happening at other plants around the country. It's not just this spent waste issue in San Onofre, right?
Oh, absolutely. There are hundreds of nuclear waste storage sites around the country. I think San Onofre is in a position to say it's in one of the most risky. It's buried there right beside the ocean. You can literally see a 28-foot wall between the storage site and the ocean. We know this sea level rise is going to happen, and perhaps faster than we predicted. So a seismic area.
Earthquakes in this part of the...
Exactly, right. You know, millions of people living right around it. So there is quite a strong push to say that if another site is found, that San Onofre's waste should be one of the first to go, but we don't know if that will happen.
Yeah, so a long way from resolution on this story here. But I did want to transition. That brings me to a personal note here. You're about